Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Journey with Vijay Kumar Srivastava. Today we are going to cover the topic soil fertility status of Jharkhand and improving soil health and concept of organic farming. First I would like to introduce myself. I am Vijay Kumar Srivastava. I have done my MSCG from J.B. Pant University of Agriculture and Technology as presently working as a seed professional in one of the MNC. In this presentation we have covered the various topics like soil and its properties, different types of soil in Jharkhand, improving soil health and soil fertility by means of using biofertilizer, nitrogen fixing bacteria, use of vermicompost, farmyard manures and concept of organic farming. Hope this presentation will be very very useful to the candidates who are preparing for agriculture competitive exams in Jharkhand and as well as other general competitions. I would like to get feedback from all of you for further improvements in my next coming presentation. So, I request all of you to subscribe my channel Journey with Vijay Kumar Srivastava and submit your feedback. Now we will proceed to the presentation. In this chapter, we will discuss about soil, soil fertility and soil productivity. First, definition of soil. Soil is defined is the thin layer of earth's crust made up of disintegrated and decomposed rocks, complex mineral compounds, organic matter, water, air and living organisms like bacteria, fungi, insects, worms, which serves as the natural medium of growth of plants. Functions of soil. Soil provides place and anchorage for plant growth and development. It serves as a medium for air and water circulation. Soil acts as a reservoir for water and nutrients, and it provides a space for beneficial microorganisms. The soil environment has been categorized in three types. First one, physical environment, which consists of morphology, soil structure, soil texture, water holding capacity, aeration, and mechanical resistance, if any. Now, chemical environment, which reflects nutrient availability, minerals, organic matters, pH, acidity and salinity. Third one is biological environment, which is consists of organisms in soil. We will discuss about soil fertility. Soil fertility is the status or inherent capacity of the soil to supply nutrients to the plants in adequate amount and in suitable proportions. According to modern usage, soil fertility is the capacity of the soil to produce crops of economic value to maintain health of the soil without deterioration. Now, soil productivity. Soil productivity is the capacity of the soil to produce crops with specific systems of management and is expressed in terms of yields. All productive soils are fertile, but all fertile soil needs not be productive. So, here we have to understand the difference between soil fertility and soil productivity. Soil types of Jharkhand. The soils of Jharkhand may broadly be classified into five groups. First one is red soil, second one is sandy soil, third is black soil, fourth is laterite soil, and fifth is red micaceous soil. So now we will go one by one. First one is red soil. These soils are made by the decomposition of crystalline metamorphic rocks such as granite and gneiss. The color of the soil is reddish, which is because of high content of iron oxide at some places, and at many places it is just like chocolate, which is dark in color. This type of soil is found in most of the Jharkhand, about covering 90% of area, but it is not available in trough basins of Damodar and in Rajmahal areas. In these soils we can grow the crops jowar, bajra, groundnut, sugarcane and rice. The properties of red soils are: it is less fertile. Red soils are acidic in reaction with pH value 5 to 5.6. It has high iron content, low base exchange capacity. It is porous with shallow to medium soil depth, and it has adequate quantities of lime and potash. Second one is sandy soil. This type of soil is found in East Hazaribagh and Dhanbad. These two areas compose the trough basins of Damodar, which is famous for sandy soil. Such soil is formed by the gradual decomposition and sandstones, sandy loam and sandy soils. The crop can be grown are coarse cereal, which is covering ragi, this bajra, jowar and other coarse millets. The properties of these soils are, it is yellowish in color, it is poor humus content and it is less fertile. Third one is black soil. The soil is found in the Rajmahal areas. The soil of Rajmahal contains basalt. The main ingredients of black soils are kaolin, potash and iron oxides. This soil has higher proportion of clay, which has a very high water retaining capacity. The areas with higher elevations has thin layer of black soil with light color, but in areas with lower heights, the soil has thick layer and dark color. The crops which can be grown in black soils are rice, gram and cotton. The main properties of black soils are, it has high water retaining capacity, it contains lime, iron, magnesium and lacking in nitrogen, biological substances and phosphorus. Black soil becomes sticky after getting water, and these soils in lower areas is more fertile. Fourth one is laterite soil. The laterite soil is found in the highlands of Rajmahal, western Rachi Plateau and pet regions of South Palamu, Dalbhum areas of Singhbhum. The main components of these soils are aluminium, iron oxide and manganese oxide. The main defects of laterite soils that these soils are acidic reactions, and the main crops of these soils are castor, pigeon pea and ragi. If irrigation facilities are available, then we can grow rice and sugarcane also. The main properties of laterite soils are, it has high iron content, it has low content of phosphorus, nitrogen and potash, it is prone to acidic reaction and it has low crop yield. Now last one is red micaceous soil. This soil is mostly found in mica areas of Jharkhand, such as Koderma, Mandu, Jhumritalaya, Barkagaon and areas around Mandar Hills. The soil becomes light pink in areas of dry and higher elevation and yellow color in low elevations with high moisture. The crops can be grown in these soils are ragi and kurmi. And the main properties of red micaceous soils are, soil acidity together with low potassium and sulfur content. It has moderate nitrogen content, deficient in zinc, copper and boron, which indicates the low fertility of the soil. So such soils require attention on soil management practices for optimum agriculture production. In this chapter, we have discussed the soil fertility status of Jharkhand. Soil fertility is the aspect of soil plant relationship. Fertility status dependent on macro and micro nutrient reserves of the soil. Continued removal of nutrients by crop with little or no replacement will increase the nutrient stress in plant and ultimately lowers the productivity. The fertility status of soil mainly depends on nature of vegetation, climate, topography, texture of soil and decomposition rate of organic matter. As per GIS based data, GIS refers to the geographical information system. As soil fertility can be mapped, nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium are the major constituents which are considered important for soil fertility. Lohardaga and Simdoga districts have less percentage of nitrogen. Palamu, Chatar, Koderma, Giridi, Dumka, Godda, Sahabganj areas have less percentage of phosphorus. And other side, Koderma, Latehar, Deoghar, Simdega, Dumka areas have high percentage of potassium and Dhanbad has low percentage of potassium. Jharkhand soil in general are low to very low in available phosphorus, medium in available nitrogen and potassium status and deficient in boron. Now soil orders in Jharkhand. There are four soil orders. First one is alfi soils, which are dominant soils and it is covering 50% of total geographical areas of Jharkhand. Second one is inceptive soils, which is covering around 25% of total geographical area. Intisols, which is covering around 20% of total geographical area, and vertisols are very negligible and having only 1% of total geographical areas. Now we will go through nitrogen fixing bacteria and their applications. The nitrogen fixing bacteria are induced in soil by using biofertilizer. Biofertilizers are microorganism culture capable of fixing atmospheric nitrogen when crops are inoculated with them. Nitrogen fixing bacteria are microorganisms which are capable of transforming atmospheric nitrogen into fixed nitrogen where inorganic nitrogen compounds are usable by plants. There are two types of nitrogen fixing bacteria. First one is symbiotic mutualistic bacteria. In this case, there is symbiotic relation between bacteria and plant, host plant, where host plant is providing the space to the bacteria, where bacteria is growing in nodules or plant root nodules, and in other way, in return, these bacteria are supplying nitrogen to plant. So there is beneficial relationship between them. In this type of bacteria, the rhizobium culture are associated with leguminous crop, which belongs to pea family crops, where almost 50% demand of nitrogen is met by these microorganisms. Second one is asymbiotic free living bacteria, which includes culture of Azotobacter, Azoaspergillum, Cyanobacteria or blue grain algae, Azolla, Mycorrhiza, Anabina, Nostoc and genera such as Bezerenkia and Clostridium. Symbiotic nitrogen fixing bacteria invades the root hairs of host plant where they multiply and stimulate formulation of root nodules, enlargement of plant cells and bacteria in intimate association with plant. Within the nodules, the bacteria convert free nitrogen to ammonia, which the host plant utilizes for its development. So there is beneficial symbiotic relation between bacteria and plant. Second one is asymbiotic nitrogen fixing bacteria, which grow on decomposing soil organic matter and produce nitrogenous compound for their own growth and development. And besides, they leave behind a significant amount of nitrogen in surroundings, which is useful for plant growth. Means in this case, there is no relation between plant and bacteria. The nitrogen is produced by bacteria for their own growth and development, and these nitrogenous compounds are used by plant also. Application of nitrogen fixing bacteria, where more than 90% of all nitrogen fixation by these organisms playing important role in nitrogen cycle. They increase soil productivity and fertility and helps plant with necessary amount of nitrogen compounds, hence helping growth of plant. In this chapter, we have covered the application of vermicompost and farmyard manures. Vermicompost is the product of the decomposition process using various species of worms, usually red wigglers, white worms, and other earthworms to create a mixture of decomposing vegetables or food waste, bedding materials, and vermicast to transform organic waste into a nutrient-rich fertilizer and ensure high quality compost material that is added to soil to improve soil quality. Vermicast is the end product of breakdown of organic matter by earthworms. Second one is farmyard manure. It is a decomposed mixture of cattle dung and urine with straw and litter used in bedding material and residue from fodder fed to cattle and agriculture wastes. Compost, a moss of rotted organic matter made from agriculture waste, is called compost. It is made farm wastes as a sugarcane trash, paddy straw, weed, stubble, bhusa, sewage, and sludge, etc. So these all vermicompost, farmyard manure, compost increase the quality of soil by increasing the amount of various essential nutrients, helps crop growing faster and healthier. It do not worsen the quality of soil even after multiple usage. Now we will go through concept of organic farming. Organic farming is a method of farming system which primarily aims at cultivating the land and raising crops in such a way as to keep the soil alive and in good health by use of organic wastes like crop, animal and farm waste, aquatic wastes and other biological materials along with beneficial microbes which are biofertilizers to release nutrients to crops for increased sustainable production in an eco-friendly, pollution-free environment. As per the definitions of United States Department of Agriculture, USDA, a study team on organic farming revealed that organic farming is a system and to the maximum extent feasible rely upon crop rotations, crop residues, animal manures, off-farm organic waste, mineral-grade rock additives and biological systems of nutrient mobilization and plant protection. Food and Agriculture Organization FAO suggested that organic agriculture is a unique production management system which promotes and enhances agro-ecosystem health including biodiversity, biological cycles and soil biological activity, and this is accomplished by using on-farm agronomic, biological and mechanical methods in exclusion of all synthetic off-farm inputs. Means in organic farming, we are using only biological sources, organic matters, and completely keeping out the inorganic forms or chemicals or synthetic inputs. Here we have shown the organic farming cycles, where we are using biological management, crop rotations, green leaf manures, vermicompost, manures, biofertilizers, and animal husbandry. So here there is no place for chemicals and synthetic additives for growing crops. Green manuring. Green manuring is the plowing under or soil incorporation of any green manure crops while they are green or soon after they flower. Green manures are forages or leguminous crops that are grown for their leafy materials needed for adding organic matter to the soil and soil conservation. Green manuring with legumes improves soil nitrogen fixation through biological nitrogen fixation and it increases the nitrogen content of soil. Sunhams and dhecha are these two crops are most favorable for green manuring. Now we will go through need of organic farming. With the increase in population, our compulsion would be not only to stabilize agriculture production, but to increase it further in sustainable manner. The scientists have realized that the green revolution with high input use has reached a plateau and is now sustained with diminishing return of falling dividends. Thus, a natural balance needs to be maintained at all cost for existence of life and property. The obvious choice for that would be more relevant in present era where these agrochemicals, which are produced from fossil fuel and are not renewable and are diminishing in availability. It may also cost heavily on our foreign exchange in future. So, there are some key characteristics of organic farming, which is including protecting the long-term fertility of soils by maintaining organic matter levels, encouraging soil biological activity and careful mechanical interventions, providing crop nutrients indirectly using relatively insoluble nutrient sources which are made available to the plant by action of soil microorganisms, nitrogen self-sufficiency through the use of legumes and biological nitrogen fixation, as well as effective recycling of organic materials including crop residues and livestock manures, weed, disease and pest control relying primarily on crop rotations, natural predators, diversity, organic manuring, resistance varieties and limited, preferably minimum, thermal, biological and chemical interventions needs. The extensive management of livestock, paying full regard to their evolutionary adaptations, behavioral needs and animal welfare issues with respect to nutrition, housing, health, breeding and rearing. Careful attention to the impact of the farming system on the wider environment and the conservation of wildlife and natural habitats. So organic farming is playing very great important role where we are focusing the sustainable development of agriculture using biological methods, these biofertilizer for nitrogen fixation and these organic and animal wastes which are incorporated to the soil for increasing fertility. And here we are totally avoiding the agrochemicals which are having the harmful effects on nature and health. So the organic farming will play as an important role in future for the sustainable development of agroclimatic zones, agriculture and human health considerations. So this was all about fertility, nutrient supplement to the plants, organic farming. So my presentation ends here. Thank you very much for your kind attention. Here we have shown the my YouTube channel details, Journey with Vijay Kumar Srivastava, and already I have published lot of contents. Please go through the YouTube channel and subscribe it. Thank you very much.